Once again, big welcome from your Saturday show 321. And this week we've got a great theme for you because it's magic is the theme of our show. We've got some wonderful acts you'll be astounded at a bit later on in our show, you know. And I mean, one theatre critic thinks I'm a magician. He says every time I play his theatre, the audience disappears. I don't know what that means. But it's a great life. And when you think about the great magicians we have, we've got a wonderful one right now in this country, Paul Daniels. I think you'll agree. He's wonderful, isn't he? I mean, Paul really, he's only ever done one thing wrong. That's when he tried to play a trick on an African witch doctor. That's why he's that big. Thank you. Now I'd like you to come along and meet my assistant. The only trouble is when he appears, the only way you're going to get rid of him is to say reject. That's our little booby prize, Dusty Bin. Here he is. Come on, Dust. Oh, yeah. And dressed up, of course, as a magician. Look at all, he's always got tricks that sort of work one way and the other. I don't think this one will it? But let's have a look. Yes, it will. Look at that, a ripple for that. And a different trick. Each time he's got something up his sleeve. But of course, remember, he is the booby prize. All they get if they take him, they win him, is in fact a brand new dustbin. That's all they get. I'm going to say abracadabra, hey presto, and make six people appear. They're the people without whom we just couldn't do the show. They're our contestants. Here they are.
Len and Debbie Rye from Newmarket. David and Corrie Meek from Fife. Martin and Wendy Cole from Plymouth.
And indeed, our first couple tonight are Martin and Wendy Cole from Plymouth in Devon. Great part of the world there. And Martin, what do you do for a living?
I'm a trainee combined tradesman in the dockyard at Plymouth.
In the dockyard? It says, yes, a mature apprentice, it says.
That's right, yeah.
Not an immature one, a mature one.
Not quite 16.
Working lady, Wendy?
Yes.
What do you do?
I'm some hairdressers.
Hairdressers? Hey, that's always big business, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
You two met at the YMCA at one weekend when Martin was playing snooker and you were playing for a ladies' football team. Really? I mean, was that a serious football team?
Yes.
I mean, what position did you play?
Oh, well, it was just five-a-side, so it was, you know, anything.
That's even heavier, isn't it, five-a-side? I bet the ref took everybody's name that day. Good, make them feel at home, folks, will you? Good luck. Yes. Here we have Len and Debbie Rye, and you're from Burwell in Cambridgeshire. Lovely part of the world. And what sort of work do you do, Len?
I'm a British Telecom engineer.
British Telecom, eh?
Work in the exchange.
Debbie, you... You used to be a telephone operator, or did you or not?
No, I'm a secretary.
I see, and who's that for?
Norwegian Insurance.
Uh-huh, lovely. And Deb, so what about, he says you like making desserts, yeah?
Yes.
What's your favourite dessert?
Oh, anything gooey and fattening.
Gooey and fattening, we all love that one, yeah? My mum's got a great recipe. She makes, Australian upside-down cake, and it comes up the right way up, the way she makes it. Make them feel at home, will it? Good to hear. Corrine? Ah, yes. David and Corrine. Corrine Meek, and you're from a lovely part of the world, Inverkeithing. I say that right? Because I have been up there. I was in Kirkcaldy. That's Fife, and that's that way, isn't it? One day we went across to St Andrews, and it's a lovely part of the world. I mean, you actually come from there? Were you born there?
I was born there.
Yes? Uh-huh. And what do you do for a living then?
I'm a senior bank officer.
Senior bank officer?
Yes.
Oh, great, yeah. That's big. Is it with the Scottish banks, or is it with
it's
the...
It's with one of the Scottish banks,
yeah. Because they have one of the talking cash dispensers up there.
That's right.
Yeah, you know about that.
Well, we know a lot of
it. Yeah. Well, I used one. It says to me, are you sure you have to make this withdrawal? That was a Scottish one. And how about you? What do you do in the MDA? Corrine, do you work?
I used to work in the bank as well, but now I don't work.
No, because you have the children, yeah?
That's right, yes. Little boy.
How old is he?
13 weeks.
13 weeks? Yeah. Very, very... Oh, lovely. That's great. Good. Uh-huh. So you're quite busy? You're finding things busy at home?
Very busy.
Very busy. I'm sure you have. Well, let's hope you're going to have a good night tonight. Make them feel at home, will you? Good you're here. Nice to have you with us. Okay, it's time for the quiz. Remember, we do play two rounds of questioning. They play for £10 for each correct answer in the first round. The amount they win at the end of the first round is what they play for each correct answer in the second round. At the end of the quiz, couple with the lowest amount of money leaves us then, leaving the remaining two couples to play right through part two. Let's meet the lady with the questions. That's Caroline Munro. She's here. Okay, Caroline. Magic is our theme, and another magical outfit, too, huh?
Sparkly.
Indeed it is. Let's play the quiz, shall we? Let's go and meet now couple number one. That's Martin and Wendy. One of those three envelopes is for you. Okay, Wendy.
Thank
thanks,
you.
Caroline. Now, you know we like you to answer alternately, Wendy. Okay, yes. You first. Two ways we can stop you if you make a mistake or run out of time. We do ask you to say don't know or pass if you don't know an answer, because that way you can build up your score. No. I must accept the first answer you give me. Yes. So that's why it's be very, very careful there with guesses. Okay, we'll let you have one to start here. The question is about Beatles song titles. We will give you the first part of the title. We want you to add the last word. Now, Day Tripper was a number one for 12 weeks. So we'll start you with that one. Day
Tripper.
I feel
fine.
From me to
you.
Yellow.
Pass.
Strawberry Fields.
Pass.
Lady.
Pass.
The Ballad of John and
Pass.
Lucy in the Sky with
Diamonds.
Love Me.
Pass.
And Norwegian
Wood.
Norwegian Wood it was. I'm sure you know these when they come out the other way. What did we know? Yellow Submarine. Now you remember that one. Strawberry Fields. Can you remember that now?
Yeah.
Forever. Lady Madonna was what we wanted. Mm. Also, The Ballad of John and Yoko. And Love Me Do, the first hit for the Beatles. But you've not done bad. Five right gives you £50 to start. £50 is nice. Okay, Debbie and Lynn, one of those two envelopes. Caroline?
Thank you.
Okay. That's the one for you. Same procedure. Answer alternately. Yes. Hold her hand if you want to. I saw that going on. You can do that, all right. Don't forget, if you don't know, say don't know. Otherwise, you know, first answer you take, give me if it's wrong, I have to accept it. Question here, again, is about Beatles song titles. We will give you the first part of the title. We want you to give us the last word. Paperback Writer was a number one for 11 weeks, so we'll start you with that one. Paperback
Writer.
Can't Buy Me.
Pass.
Ticket to
Ride.
Eleanor.
Rigby.
Magical Mystery
Tour.
Hello.
Pass.
The Fool on the
Hill.
Got to Get You Into My
Pass.
The Long and Winding
Road.
Oobla-Dee.
Oobla-Da.
Ah, that was an easy one for yes. Oobla-Da, in fact. Got to Get You Into My Life. That was what we wanted there. Hello, Goodbye. Do you remember how you say hello? Yeah. And Can't Buy Me Love. That was another heck of a hit for the Beatles. You've done well. Seven right, £70. David and Corinne, last envelope. Thank you, Caroline. So that's the one for you. And again, it's the same question. It's about Beatles song titles. We will give you the first part of the title. We want you to give us the last word. Penny Lane was the top 10 for 11 weeks. So we'll start you with that one. Penny.
Lane.
Please, please.
Pass.
A Hard Day's
Night.
She Loves.
Pass.
I Want to Hold Your
Hand.
We Can Work It
Out.
All You Need Is
Love.
With a Little Help from My
Friends.
No, Nowhere.
Pass.
Maxwell Silver.
Pass.
Maxwell Silverhammer was the one we wanted there. Maxwell Silverhammer. Nowhere Man, a real Nowhere Man. She Loves You, yeah, one of the most famous. And Please, Please Me was the other one you didn't know. I can't sing it too well, but you've done all right. Six right, £60. Well done. At the end of the first round, yes, indeed, we've got couple number one, they've got £50. Couple number two have £60 in the lead at the moment. Couple number two here, that's Debbie and Len, they've got £70. So off we go for round two. Wendy and Martin, it's Caroline with the round two questions. Again, one of those three envelopes is for you. And it's that one. So for £50 each correct answer, good luck to you. The question here is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters PH. We will give you a definition. We want you to give us the word. Words beginning with PH. Now, a system for communicating at a distance is a phone. We'll start you with that one. A system for communicating at a distance is a
phone.
Right, a person qualified to dispense drugs.
Pharmacist.
Picture taken by a camera.
Photograph.
Long-tailed game bird.
Pheasant.
Duke of Edinburgh's Christian name.
Pass.
Ancient Egyptian ruler.
Pharaoh.
Early type of gramophone.
Pass.
A ghost or apparition.
Pass.
Violent fear of something.
Phobia.
Collecting postage stamps.
Philatelist.
Ah, we're on the button there. No, we were just outside the button. I'm sorry, I can't accept it. We've had it from the adjudicator. I can't accept it. What a shame. It was just after the time allotted there. It was indeed philately, Martin. A ghost or apparition, phantom, was what we wanted there. Early type of gramophone was a phonograph. And the Duke of Edinburgh's Christian name?
Philip.
Philip. Now he knows that. So at the end of that, £300 you got. Well done. £300. Nice. OK, Len and Debbie. Debbie chooses that one. OK, thanks, Caroline. And you're going for £70 for each correct answer. Again, the question is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters T-O. We give you the definition, you give us the word. Words beginning with T-O. A garment worn by ancient Roman is a toga. We'll start you with that one. A garment worn by an ancient Roman is a...
toga.
Right. Dried leaves that fill cigarettes.
Tobacco.
A sticky sweet.
Pass.
A poisonous fungus.
Pass.
Small portable electric lamp.
Pass.
T-O. Violent and destructive whirlwind.
Tornado.
Building for a burial.
Tomb.
An urban area.
Town.
A small wick.
Toothache.
A digit of the foot.
Toe.
A toe. Yes, indeed it was. So we've got a small portable electric lamp, was a torch.
Yeah.
He knows that now. A poisonous fungus, a toadstool. Don't ever eat one of those. Mm. A sticky sweet was a toffee, and that's about it. You've got £490. The last envelope means that's the one for Corinne and David. So you're going for £60 for each correct answer. And the question again is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters A-T. We will give you a definition. You give us the word. Words beginning with A-T. A junior member of an embassy staff is an attaché. We'll start you with that one. Junior member of an attaché. Sorry, I'll do it again. Junior member of an embassy staff is a...
attaché.
One of the oceans.
Atlantic.
Roof space.
Attic.
Track and field events.
Athletics.
Another word for lawyer.
Attorney.
Act of directing your thoughts.
Attention.
A try.
Pass.
Capital city of Greece.
Athens.
A person who waits on another.
Attendant.
Magnetic power to pull.
Attract.
Attract. Attraction we wanted, but attract is the same word anyway, virtually. The one you didn't know there was a try, which was attempt. Now you know it. You didn't want to take the chance. I don't blame you, because at the end of that, you got £540. Well done. £540. And the two letters given to each of our couples this week spelt out T-O-P-H-A-T, top hat, of course, which ties in with this week's theme of It's Magic. But at the end of our quiz this week, we got couple number one on £300. And indeed, we have got couple number two. That's Debbie and Len. They got £490. The winners of the quiz, couple number three, £540. David and Corinne for either in the keeping. So I have to say goodbye to Martin and Wendy here with 300 quid. It's not a bad night's work, though, is it?
Very good.
And I always say it seems to go very quick for us, this part of the show, but it's, I bet it seemed like an eternity sitting there.
Yeah.
Very good. It has. However, there's £300. You've done very well indeed.
Amazing.
There's the ceramic dusty bin.
Thank you.
And you know what they like to get a hold of.
Yes.
Give them a great round of applause. So thanks, Wendy.
Thank you.
Take care. Thanks, Martin. Stay with us. Lovely sport. Thank you. Time for us to go away for the break. We'll be back very soon on 3-2-1. See you in a minute. Take care. Bye. Two or three, two, one. The theme this week is It's Magic, and we've got Len and Debbie there from Cambridgeshire, and they're playing against David and Corinne, who are from Inverkeithing in Scotland. You know what happens here, folks? At the end of each one of the items we're going to show you, somebody will come here to the table, leave a clue object, and read you a rhyme. When we have three on the table, I'm going to ask both couples to select one they'd like to reject if they're going to be the fortunate... Oh, God bless, she's coughing already. Going to be the fortunate couple to get through. So, good luck to everybody. Hope you have a good time. I'm sure you will. We're going to have item number one. And for this, we've got a young man who's making an enormous reputation for himself all over the country. Ladies and gentlemen, greet Martin Daniels.
Thank you very much. Good evening. My name is Martin Daniels, and this show is all about magic and magicians. You've seen magicians. They've all got their beautiful and glamorous assistants. You wait until you see mine. Ted? Wonderful. Smash it. Nice to see you. It's great for you to help.
Not at all. Pleasure.
Had I in my mouth, wouldn't let me use it. Right. What we're going to do, over here, we've got two invisible tables. One blue one and one red one. Now, just ignore the blue one. I'd like you to grab hold of the red one and just bring it and put it down in the middle so that everybody can see it.
The red one?
The red one.
You don't want the blue one?
Not the blue one. Ignore the blue one. Otherwise, that gets very confusing if there's two tables.
You want the red one?
Just the red one. No, the red one.
The red one. Sorry.
You're colourblind.
Sorry.
Great.
The red one.
Put that down. Smash
okay.
it. Now, on the table there, you can see there's a pack of cards.
Lovely.
I'd like you to just pick the cards up. It's great. Now, just give them a good old shuffle. That's it, shuffle.
Oh, great.
You better take them out of the packet first, though. It's, makes life a lot easier. Just put the box on the table. Now, if you shuffle them, now what we're going to do, we're just to... Oh, dear. Oh, you dropped them. Oh. Take hours to find.
No, I'll get them.
I'll cover for you, don't worry.
It's all right, Martin, I've got them.
You've done it.
Yeah,
great.
I've got it, here.
Smashing. Now then, what I want you to do is just spread all the cards out on the table, face up.
Face up?
Face up, so that we can see them all. That's great. Oh, the table's higher. Right. What I want you to do is just take a card out.
Just one?
Just one, but don't let me see it. I'll look the other way. So
it's all right, yeah, I've got it.
You've got the card. Now, just show it to the studio audience.
Oh.
And and show it to the camera so the people at home can't see it as well. You done it?
Yeah.
That's smashing. Great. Now, what I'm going to do, just put it back in the pack.
Yeah.
But face down.
So you can't see it?
So I can't see it. Otherwise, it makes life a lot easier if I can see it. Now, you just gather all the cards up and just put them into the box.
Back in the box?
Back in the box that's on the table. That's smashing. It's great. You do it very well. Now, if I have the cards back, I just take them and I put them into my pocket like this, inside pocket. Now, then all I do, we talk along for a little while.
Yeah.
And then hopefully the heat from my body will make the cards become visible again.
The heat?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And if you believe that, you'll knit wire netting. Now, what we do, inside here, actually, I do have a pack of cards.
Ah.
See? Could be the same pack. Now, you're probably wondering why we've done all this.
Yeah, why is that?
I don't know myself, really, but... So, gentlemen sit in... One, two, three rows back, blue sweater, likes his nose so much he's had it underlined. Gentlemen there. Now, be honest, be loud, be clear. Have you ever met me before?
No.
No? How do you know it's me, then? The old jokes of the rest. Would you like to just name any card?
Two of spades.
The two of spades?
Two of spades.
Now, he could have picked any card.
Any card, but he chose the two of spades.
And you could have picked any card out of the invisible.
I did, but I picked which I didn't let you see. They saw it.
Yeah, I've got the gentleman to pick it, because otherwise people might think it's a fiddle if you said it. Now, you take hold of the box, because this afternoon I had a premonition, and it wore off, so I had another one. And the second one was much better than the first one. And I took a pack of cards, and in this pack of cards, I just turned one card round, and one card, I just go through, you can see all the other cards are the right way round, and they're all different as well. And I took a card, and I reversed it in the pack. Now, what we did, we messed around with an invisible deck, and you picked one and reversed it. Could be the same deck.
That's right.
Gentlemen in the audience, name the two of spades.
Two of spades.
Just so happens that the card reversed in my pack is the two of spades. Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Martin Daniels.
Yeah. Listen, apart from them, we worked together at Margate, I remember.
Margate, yeah, a couple of years ago now.
That's right, and you're in the middle of a pantomime right now.
Yeah, I'm at the Empire Theatre in Liverpool.
Yeah, that's
in
a big one. Good that you're with us. Anyway, what are you leaving them as the clue?
I'm leaving radishes.
Radishes, okay.
There's a clue.
There's the clue. And what's the rhyme say, Martin?
And the rhyme says, you see magic done by hand, will you basically understand?
And that's all there is to it.
That's...
What do you say to that, David? Any idea?
And radish, horse radish.
Yes.
Something to do with horses.
Yeah, horses or a bit of roast beef. You never know. Let's thank Martin Daniels. Thanks, Martin.
Thanks.
Good luck.
Have a good season.
Bye, mate. There's Len having a good chat to Debbie. What do you think it could be? He said something about horses. What do you think?
Some do hands and tools.
Hand tools. Well, at least you're thinking in the right direction, and that's good because that's the first one on the table. We'll get on, have item number two. And here we're going to welcome back a lady from France, all the way from France to be with us today, the enchanting Chantal Valery.
Thank you.
Chantal, Valery. From France, of course,
yes,
Chantal.
Paris.
Paris.
Yes,
well, you said Paris like I would say, and I said Paris like you should say it. Lovely city to come from. And you're not going back there, are you? Because I believe you're going off to Germany.
Yes, and also in Copenhagen.
In Copenhagen.
Yes,
that's a nice city too. Yes. What are you going to leave these folks here as a clue then?
It's a wig.
A wig?
Yes.
Okay, a wig is the clue. And can you read English?
Or no? It's impossible for
Impossibly?
Me. Too difficult.
I will do it for you. Ladies and gentlemen, Chantal Valery. Thank you. Okay, folks, she's left you a wig there as the clue, and this is what her rhyme said. You'd wipe the floor before, then sling, but that's slang for. There you are. Not too easy, eh, Corinne? What do you think?
Still thinking about radishes.
You're still thinking about the radishes. What do you say, Len? Any idea what you think that is?
Well, I don't need a new wig.
Don't need a new wig. Well, I tell you what, that is the second item. One more on the table, then, of course, you'll be able to hear those two again to make up your minds. But then we're going to have to lose one of these charming couples here. So we will get on and item number three. Now, all magicians have got to start somewhere, and where better than Mike's Magic Market?
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is an emporium devoted to jokes and novelties, is it
not? That is now that you've walked in.
Now, I'm looking for something faintly ridiculous.
Oh, yeah? Have a look in that mirror.
No, please, let me explain. You see, I desperately want to impress my curate.
Oh, yes? What about giving him a flush?
Pardon?
Oh, you!
Dear, oh, dear. No. Let me explain. You see, at last year's church concert, my curate was a resounding success. And this year it's my turn, and I want to go one better.
I see. What about sawing a curate in half?
Oh, that sounds wonderful. Do you think I could do it?
Of course you could. It's as easy as falling off a font. Falling off a font?
Yes.
Come, I'll give you a practical demonstration.
Oh, heavens.
Now, then, here we are. Oh, the box out like so.
This is it.
This is the one now, then. Oh, how about that?
Wonderful.
Okay, we open it up now.
Am I going in there?
Yes, you're going in there now. Get the steps over there. There we go. Come around the front. Now then, can you manage to get in?
Just a minute.
Yes. Careful now, up the steps. Oh, careful with the dress. There we are. In she goes now.
Right.
That's nicely. Very good.
Dearly beloved.
Please. No commercials.
I'm sorry.
Get
just
in the box,
just
will
you? Have it, you see. Oh,
now
you're going to take my hat.
Okay, there we are. Lovely, thank you.
What do I do?
Okay. What do I do? There then. Put your feet through that end.
Yes.
There we are. Feet through the end. Little tootsie peg through the end.
Through there.
That's the one, yes.
Yes.
And the head, let me just lift this up here. There we are.
Yes.
Now then, put the head through.
Oh,
okay. Take that out of the way.
Right.
Okay, there we are.
I'm in.
You in, dear boy?
Yes.
Now then, close that down there.
Yes.
There we go. Now, I'll just pop this back in here.
Yes.
Well, we'll just wait. There we are. That'll just keep your head, you see, in place.
Oh, I see.
Now, I'll just move that there. And we'll just put the little things in here. And that one in.
Yeah.
And there. Now then, just move it around like so.
Yes.
A little too deep. I'll take the shoes off.
Oh, I'm sorry, yes.
Yes, there we are.
Right.
There we go.
Yes.
That one there. How's that?
Chicky.
Little cheek. Yes. Now then, round this way.
Yes.
How's that now?
Yes. I think it's all right.
Nice and comfy,
yes,
isn't
I'm fine. Yes.
Move it around like so. Now then, okay?
Yes.
Now, this is the tricky bit coming up now. The old saw.
Oh, my God.
My kangaroo down, Jim.
Are you sure you know what you're doing?
What? I've done this trick over 100 times before. Oh. Don't be worrying. I've just got a bucket here.
What's that for?
I'll put it just in case there's any blood. Pop it underneath there like that. Okay.
Yes.
Now then, we put it in the middle like so, and we go...
Oh, 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 dear. Oh,
right now. There's a grizzly bit there. There we are. Beautiful, out she comes. Here we are, this is the clever bit now. Da, 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 I do my own music. La, da, 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 da. Now we pop that in like so. Then we've another one here. Same thing, oh my God. We pop that in like so. How's that? Nice and comfy?
Yes, I think
okay,
so.
Okay, this is the bit now that's coming up. We unhitch the thing like so. We unhitch the thing like so. And we just go. Ta-da! How does it do it? Now then, look around like so. What do you think of that then?
I think it's wonderful.
I bet you've never seen your feet from that position before.
No, I haven't, no.
I smell them either, probably. I tell you what, let's get this over here out of the way like so. In she goes there like that. Now then, what do you think of it then?
Well, I think it's absolutely marvellous.
All right, 250 quid, it's yours.
Oh, how fortunate. Do you know that's just what I have in my wallet?
Good, where is it?
It's in my back pocket.
Never mind. Leave it in there and I'll help myself later.
Oh.
Now, can I run you home?
Oh, no, please, please, no more jokes. Put me back together and we'll settle up.
Put me together again. Okay, sit tight now.
Yes.
Here we are. We pull this back out again, like so. Just do the little cat please up like that. And on the other side, like this.
Oh,
okay, now
yes.
I just go.
Oh, 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 well, what a draft.
So, come around here. How's that, sir?
What?
Short back inside. It's the new style, you know. It's called gently gray. There we are. How's that?
Yes, all right now.
Take this piece out here, the little necky-necky. Okay, now I'll move it around again.
Yes.
Okay, nice and straight. Okay, you ready for this?
Yes, take me out.
Okay. Oh. This one's here. Move this to here.
Wonderful.
All right.
Yes.
Now then.
Now then.
Well, come on, let's sweep.
255.
All I'm going to do is this. I'm going to astound.
These are not my legs. What have you done?
Well, that's very strange. The same thing happened yesterday. A dancer walked out of here wearing a coal miner's bottom.
You must have given me her legs. I thought you said you'd done the trick 100 times.
Well, I have. The thing is, I've never got it right yet.
What am I going to do?
Well, with legs like that, there's only one thing you can do.
What?
Marry me! Listen, let's go and find the jury.
What about, well, with legs like that, don't ever join the army. As you there. What are you going to leave these folks?
Well, there you go. I'm going to leave you a shoe.
Okay.
Okay.
One shoe. And
one shoe.
Them?
Here's the clue. Chris got wrong-footed. In touch, should you put it?
Hey, another difficult one, then. What do you say to that?
Could be the bin. Maybe.
Could be the bin.
Could
well,
be.
We've got all sorts of things here tonight, but we're going to thank
there
Chris.
You go.
Thank
there
you, Chris.
You are. Good
Take
luck.
It easy
Good
on
luck.
The way home. What do you think, David?
Wrong-footed. You'd kick it into touch. So
wrong-footed? You'd kick it into touch, so what would that mean?
I mean, get rid of it.
Get out? Oh, I see. Well, OK, you've just heard that from Chris. Now we do have three on the table, and I can read the other two again for you to refresh your memories. Remember, the radishes were brought in by Martin Daniels. Number one item, Martin said, you see magic done by hand, will you basically understand? OK? OK, good. The wig was brought in by Chantal Valery. The rhyme said, you'd wipe the floor before, then sling, but that's slang for. Nothing from Corinne, but what do you say? Any idea what you think any of them are, or which one you'd like to get rid of if you... How about you, Debbie?
Shoe.
What do you think?
I'll get rid of the shoe.
You want to get rid of the shoe?
Shoe.
Yes?
Yes.
David?
No.
Corinne says no.
Boot.
So why don't you want to get rid of the shoe?
The wig.
You want to get rid of the wig?
Get rid of the wig.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay. We've gone from the shoe to the wig,
yes.
And you're not even through yet. But anyway, that's what you're going to get rid of, then. You want to get rid of the wig, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, and you're going to get rid of the radishes.
No? Shoe.
You've gone to the shoe. Let's get this straight again. You're going to get rid of the shoe.
Yep.
You're going to get rid of the wig.
Yes.
Okay, here we go. The elimination question is here. Put your hands beside the button there. Now, I'm going to start to read the question. When you think you know the answer, hit it and answer. If you do answer before hitting the button, I've got to offer it to the other couple, OK? If they're wrong, of course, once you have answered, I will carry on reading it until somebody gets it right. Good luck to you. Here's the question. This is a comedy magician. He was born in Caer Philly in South Wales. His routines combine fumbled conjuring. Who is it, David?
Tommy Cooper.
It's Tommy Cooper. You're absolutely right. Yes, well done. About hitting that button and taking the chance. You were absolutely right to take the chance, and you were right, of course, but the bit that got me was Caer Philly. I don't know whether many people know that Tommy Cooper, of course, was born in Caer Philly in South Wales. However, that means, of course, you're going through to the big prizes. Good luck to you. And we have to say goodbye to Debbie and Len right now, but Caroline, of course, is here with the money you won in the quiz. What was that again, Caroline?
£490.
They won. Well done. There's the salami stuff we did. A little consolation prize for you. Just take a look across there at Martin Daniels. Martin has for you a leather compendium of cards, backgammon, and tarot cards, and a box of magic tricks. There we are. Thanks very much indeed. Good luck to you, Len. Debbie, take care. Thanks for coming. Give them a great round of applause, folks. Thanks a lot. Take care. Come on. Oh. Hey. Now then. Okay. David took the courage in his hands. He hit the button, and of course he was right. How do you feel now? Nervous. Well, don't be nervous. All you've got to worry about is getting rid of the dusty bin in part three, and we'll be back in just a couple of minutes to see what it is they've rejected. See you in a minute. Welcome to part three. This week's 3-2-1 is It's Magic, and we've got David and Corinne, who are from In the Keating. I've got it at last, haven't I?
Keating.
Oh, that's the way you say it. I'll get it by the end of the show. You've rejected the wig. Would you like to hold that, David? Send it back to Ernie Wise. I'll do something with it. Brought in by Chantal Valery. She said, or I said for her, you'd wipe the floor before, then sling, but that's slang for. So, what do you think it is? What do you hope it is? We hope it's the bit. Let's have a look, see what it says. Chantal brought you in the wig, and of course the rhyme said you'd wipe the floor before. That might have made you think of Dusty, obviously it did, or as something which might require you to wipe the floor before putting it down. Then sling, but that's slang for. Sling could be something you throw down, but the slang connected really referred to the wig. Now, slang for wig is rug. Yeah, and that's what this price is. We have here with us this evening a designer who would have designed you a rug especially for the two of you. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. John French. Hey. Now then, John, I mean, really magnificent work. I mean, they, of course, could have taken any rug of their choice. And, of course, you do make them to what the customer needs. Is that right? If they wanted a particular design, you would have done that.
We would indeed, yes.
But I think you'll agree that it's a fabulous, fabulous piece of merchandise. It really is. And, of course, costs quite a penny, I can tell you that. But, of course, it has been rejected. John, thank you very much indeed for coming along. Continued success with the business. And, of course, we will go on and have item number four. This time, it's going to be a magical interpretation of some magical music by magical dancers, the Brian Rogers Connection. Yes. As you can hear, I think our audience are a bit choked. You didn't come in from that side. Anyway, another great knockout routine, of course. Brian, he always comes up with these routines each week, not only for us, because once we finish our season, we're only sort of midway through at the moment, but what are you doing?
Well, we're with you until February, then we're off to do another series of live at Her Majesty's.
What are you going to leave them as the clue?
Well, I'm going to leave the wand.
Mm-hmm. And the rhyme?
And the rhyme is, the wand could make things disappear, just pour cold water on this idea.
Pour cold water on this idea. How about that, David?
No idea.
Let's thank Bonnie. Bonnie of the Brian Rogers Connection. Good luck, Bonnie. Yeah. Just a little bit of bias there, that's all. Okay, any idea what you think it could be there? Well, we have two more on the table. I can read one of the other two again. The radishes brought in number one item, remember?
Could we hear the shoe, please?
You could hear the shoe, yes, of course. The shoe was brought in by Chris Emmett. Chris said, Chris got wrong-footed, in touch should you put it. That was what Chris Emmett said. Three on the table, one of them has to be rejected. What's it going to be?
A shoe, I think.
A shoe.
Shoe? Yeah. Why do you think that? In touch? Is that what you're thinking about?
In touch. Yeah? Shoe's useless unless you've got one leg.
Yeah, well, yes, the shoe is useless unless you've got one leg. Okay, Corinne, you're going to go along with that?
Okay.
Is that all right?
Yes.
Okay, you're going to reject the shoe brought in by Chris Emmett. Chris got wrong-footed. Well, he certainly finished up with the wrong legs in the sketch. Perhaps the shoe was meant to be a hint to give this the boot, as you were thinking about, David, or even to kick it. In touch, should you put it? You should have put it. You certainly shouldn't have taken it. Dusty bin, you've done it, yeah. So, well done. Yes, you've rejected it. And, of course, that's the most important thing out of the way, OK? When one good prize goes, you get the feeling, don't you, always the next one going to be a good one? You're in a good position. He's gone, which means you go home with a great prize tonight, OK? We are now going to have Act 5, our last item. And here we have one of the most dangerous escapes ever to be performed, and our contestants are going to take part in this. So, Caroline, would you just like to come in and take David and Corinne over to the stage, please? All right? Don't worry, nothing dangerous. Really, I promise you. Thank you. Because here, ladies and gentlemen, we have the triple underwater escape performed by Faust and Company. David and Corinne are checking the equipment. The churn of water will be secured by 4 padlocks, the lid of the box by 8, and the cage door by 3. That's 15 padlocks in all. And here to attempt this unique, dangerous underwater escape, Faust. You have less than 2 minutes to escape once he goes underwater. Ready? Start the timing now. Thank you. gentlemen, Faust. My goodness, that's one heck of a trick. I don't know how you do it. It baffles me. Now, listen, I mean, that sort of illusion is becoming very, very popular. Suddenly, everybody's looking at magic again, which is a great thing. I love it. But, of course, you perform all around the world. What country, of all the countries you visit, would you say?
I would say from Japan and the Far East in general is excellent,
really?
For the big magic show.
Yes.
They still have huge theatres and big audiences. Very, yeah. Extremely popular out there.
Good to have you with us, Faust. What are you going to leave these folks as a clue? I mean, where have you got one?
I have one here, actually. There you are, producing a bow tie.
There you are, a bow tie for the clue. And you have a rhyme for them as well?
Yes, I have a rhyme.
What's that say?
Is it a bow or is it a bow? Keep an eye on. Where to now?
Where to now? That's the third one and the last one on the table. We're going to thank Faust and company. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, Faust. Thanks, Faust. What do you think about that one, Corinne? Any idea?
I think two. You wonder where you're going in a car.
So. Wonder where you're going in a car. That's what you think about that. Well, of course, we have two other ones there. We've got the radishes. You've stuck with that. That's been here since the first item, right? And, of course, we've got the wand there. Which one of those two would you like to hear again?
The wand.
You want to hear the wand? Okay, David, the wand. Here, brought in by Bonnie of the Brian Rogers Connection. She said, the wand could make things disappear. Just pour cold water on this idea. Here we are. Three on the table, one's got to be rejected. You're in the fortunate position of Dusty Bin has been eliminated, so every prize is a good prize there tonight. Which one are you going to reject?
I don't fancy cold water.
You don't fancy that? No, well, you should have said that to Faust. I don't think he fancied it either.
What do you think?
What do you think,
yes,
then?
I think so.
Cold
yes?
Water.
Yes.
Right. Okay. Do you want to get rid of the wand?
Yes.
All right, then. The wand is going to be rejected, brought in by Bonnie of the Brian Rogers Connection. The wand could make things disappear. Just pour cold water on this idea. What is it for you? The wand could make things disappear. That may not sound too optimistic, but then we said, just pour cold water on this idea. Well, if you're pouring cold water in order to make things disappear, this ought to be some sort of washer, perhaps a dishwasher, or even a washer or a tumble dryer. In fact, it's not either, it's both. Just take a look at this. A washing machine, a tumble dryer, and a floor-standing dishwasher. And to complete the kitchen, we put in a hob, a built-in oven, and this upright fridge freezer as well. Well, a terrific prize, Corinne. What do you think to that, huh?
Just
moved house, and you could have done with it, I'm sure. And the washing-up machine and the dishwasher would have been good for everything. And the washer, of course, for the baby's nappies, which is how old? How old is it? 13 weeks, my goodness. However, it's been rejected. Now we're down to the final two on the table. So, of course, you can hear these both again. Remember, the radishes brought in number one item by Martin Daniels. Martin said, you see, magic done by hand, will you basically understand? That was Martin Daniels. The bow tie brought in just now by Faust. Is it a bow or is it a bow? Keep an eye on. Where to now?
That's a sailing holiday. That's a cruise. Yes.
Is it? Oh, that's good. Oh, that's a sailing holiday. It's a cruise.
Definitely.
Great.
Yeah.
But what are you going to do? There's two on the table. One's got to be rejected. So what are you going
to
do?
We don't have time to go on holiday because... We've got a young baby, so we can't take him with us, so we'll reject that one.
So you want to reject what you think is a holiday, yes?
Yes.
Okay, David?
Yes.
That's all right.
That's
okay,
fine.
And they said get rid of the radishes. Okay. So you're going to get rid of that?
Yes.
Yes? All right, the bow tie brought in, fifth item by Faust. Is it a bow or is it a bow? Keep an eye on where to now. Look what he said. Bow. That's what you think it is. Is it a bow or is it a bow? Well, bow might refer to musical instruments. Bow might have meant dusty. If he had gone, he's gone. Keep an eye on where to now. Well, where to now might mean a holiday, as you indeed think it is. And if you put an eye on the tie, which was brought in, you'd have got eye tie. You're right, a 3-2-1 holiday to Italy. Take a look at this. We were going to take you to Heathrow, off then to the eternal city, Rome, with 6 days to spend sightseeing around the historic parts of the city and to shop in the modern areas.
dinners and evening shows during your stay, and a full day to visit Pompeii and Naples. They were also arranged for tours there. Then to Sorrento, from where you would have gone to a beautiful island, Capri. On your way back to Rome, dinner at another of Italy's leading restaurants, and then a morning to visit the Vatican, and an afternoon to the majestic Tivoli gardens and villas. All in all, another wonderful 3-2-1 holiday. What about that? You were right. Great place. Good place to go. A good place to go. Has you ever been there, David, before Italy?
Never been.
No, have you, Karim? No?
Never. He doesn't like foreign food anyway.
Doesn't like foreign food. Well, it's not bad. If you like that, I'm sure the spaghetti will go down great anywhere. However, this is the prize. You've held onto this from number one, brought in by Martin Daniels, the radishes. This is your prize. You see magic done by hand. Will you basically understand? This is what Martin said. What is it for you? You see magic done by hand, so this should be something which involves some sort of manual process. Will you basically understand? A manual process involving a basic understanding. Well, basic, as you say, is a computer language. And if we were going to give you a home computer, we'd have to give you a television as well and a compatible cassette recorder. Radishes often entail repeats, as you said about a video. We'd have thrown in a computer printer to reproduce the output to keep you entertained, a selection of video games. Take a look at this. You stayed with it all the way, and it is exactly what you thought, yes? Computer, it's all there. A fabulous prize, of course, as everything is here on 3-2-1. But there is always, if you've forgotten, the money you won in the quiz. How much was it?
£540
they won. Well done. Congratulations. Congratulations. It's been lovely having you with us. Love to that little baby. Take care. Love to everybody in Scotland. You too, David. Marvellous people. You played very well tonight. Till we see you all again next week. Have a good week. Good night, everybody. Bye-bye. Smash it. 540 shoes.